I'll cut down everything in my way. I've got enough death for everyone.
I shall take care of them.
Target locked.
I've got enough death for everyone.
Continuing mission.
The girl needed to locate the politician's ship as soon as possible. Grasping the boy's hand, she began pulling him up the beach, hoping against hope he would see a familiar sight. Suddenly, his face brightened. "Father," he cried as he slipped from her hand and began to run. The girl raced off after him. Turning around, the father smiled as his son leapt into his waiting arms. There you are, he said. You almost made me miss my meeting. The father tilted his head to mutter a word of thanks to the girl, then began carrying his son onto the ship. A sliver of a smile flickered across the girl's face before vanishing as quickly as it came. Almost as if it was never there at all. This was her ship. All that remained was to make her way aboard and learn what she could. She immediately began formulating her plan. But as her mind whirled, she noticed a woman moving silently into place behind her. The woman was familiar, for she came from the girl's own house. She had been sent to the port to monitor the girl and ensure the mission was a success. But they were never supposed to interact. Her appearance could only mean one thing. The situation had changed. The woman leaned down and whispered fiercely in the girl's ear. He means to declare war. We must act. Leave none alive.